Does your Elgato Camlink 4K randomly freeze in OBS or VMix? In this video, I'll be sharing with you why this happens and how to fix it permanently. Be sure to watch to the end of the video where I share a little bit more information about my live streaming services. So stick around. Hello again, I'm Rafi Din and welcome to Arc AV, your online resource on technical production. On this channel, I bring you tips, tools and training to help you get the best performance out of your gear and venue. Do remember to check out the links in the description below for more information about this video. And if you're new here, consider subscribing. And now, on with the video. This is the Elgato Camlink 4K. A pretty affordable HDMI capture device that works both on a PC and Mac. Since it runs on USB 3.0, it's meant to be plug and play and works right out of the box. Unfortunately, this isn't the case all the time. Now, since I have been doing my live stream tests on OBS and VMix, I noticed that the Camlink was freezing randomly throughout the day. It could take a few minutes and then the image freezes, or it could last an hour and then suddenly the image would freeze again. So I've tried a few different things to troubleshoot this by moving the device on a different port, but it seems to be reoccurring every now and then. And if I've even seen it appear, the same problem appear on Skype and Zoom, so I knew it could be a problem with the device itself. Now I have two of these devices. I bought two Camlinks and it was happening randomly between the two pieces as well. So I knew it wasn't a problem with the Camlink itself, but it could be a problem with maybe a driver or something like that. So if you own an Elgato Camlink or any other USB 3.0 HDMI capture device, you might be encountering this problem as well. So if you have been encountering any issues of the image freezing in your streaming or video capture software, I might have just the fix for you, and it definitely works. Step number one, make sure you use a USB 3.0 port. Because the Camlink is a USB 3.0 device, you have to ensure that you plug this in to a USB 3.0 port. How do you tell? As you can see, there's a blue color section inside the port here. So on your computer, it should have the blue color plastic as well. So ensure you plug this into a 3.0 port. Step number two, do not share the USB bus. Because the Camlink and other capture devices uses a lot of data and bandwidth to capture video in HD and 4K, so it's a bit choosy about other things sharing the same USB bus. What this means is, for every USB port in your computer, it might be served by one or two different buses. So in general, if you're using a desktop computer, the USB ports on the back are served by one USB bus and the ports on the front are running another USB bus. If you're using a laptop computer, the same rules apply on the left and on the right side of the computer. So you got to make sure that there is nothing else sharing the same USB bus as the Camlink or your other capture devices. This includes USB hubs, keyboards, or mice. Step number three, disable the Windows 10 USB selective suspend setting. I'll show you how to do that right now. For Windows 10 machines, the system will try to automatically power down some of your USB devices when it's not in use. This is a step to try to conserve energy and to save power for your system. But unfortunately, this messes up with some of our USB devices, just like the capture card. So how do we change this setting? I'll show you right now. So if you hop over to Windows Central, they have an article about how to disable the Windows 10 USB selective suspend setting. So basically, after going through this article, I figured that you can enter the control panel and device manager of your PC and turn off this setting for your individual ports. So what you need to do is you need to go into control panel, go to hardware and sound, and under power options, you select change power saving, and you go to change plan settings. So in here, you have to go to change advanced power settings. So once you're in advanced power settings, it'll bring you to this little pop-up. You scroll down and look for USB settings and open up USB selective suspend setting here and make sure that this setting is disabled. So if you click on this, there's a drop-down menu. You just make sure that you select disable, hit apply and okay. So once you've done this, you can double check your settings by going into the device manager. So device manager will scroll all the way down and you'll see a universal serial bus controller over here. So what you need to do is go through each and every one of these. You right click, go to properties, and on the power management tab, make sure that this box allow the computer to turn off this device to save power. Make sure that this checkbox is unchecked, right? Then go ahead to click OK. You have to do that for every single one of these USB devices. And once you're done with that, you can just go ahead to close this and restart your PC. So after you've made changes to the settings, be sure to hit apply and OK. After which, you just restart your PC and launch your Cam Link in your vMix or OBS. So far, I've never had any issues with the image freezing ever since. So this fix definitely works. So for the record, I've never actually encountered this problem on my Mac. So when I used the Cam Link on my MacBook Air, there were no image freezing problems in OBS. However, if you do encounter this problem on your iMac or your MacBook Pro, just ensure that you have set the laptop's or computer's power management settings to the high performance mode, and as well as manage the USB buses as well. So if your Cam Link is going on one side of your laptop, make sure that nothing else is plugged in on that side. And here's a little bonus tip. If you want to find out a little bit more about live streaming and would like to learn how to set up your system and get streaming, check out the link in the description below, sign up in the form, and I'll give you a video call for a free consultation on how to set things up. So check out the links in the description below. Question of the day. So what other live streaming tools do you use? Let me know your thoughts and answers in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and let me know what are the topics you would like us to cover in the comment section below. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at ArcAV Production. Don't forget to subscribe for more tips, tools, and training with ArcAV. And we'll see you in the next video.